Foundation, part publicity stunt. But the local health department has actually appealed for foreign aid because it's broke. And because the county and state governments say that with the end of federal revenue sharing, where the richer states helped out the poorer, they have no more money to give. A common problem in rural America.
We had 13 cents in our budget.
13 cents.
And owed $4,200 worth of utility bills and things.
Hinton is not one of those backcountry towns that has always had to scrape out a hard living. The town has a grand past. The freight trains just roll on by now, but in the golden age of steam, they stopped for water and coal at the major rail yard that was Hinton's lifeblood. The railroad gave Hinton its prosperity, and the railroad took it away. Where well-turned-out Hintonians once thronged to a downtown that boasted 15 hotels and 2 opera houses, today the retired elderly are left. The young have mostly gone elsewhere to seek work. Where once it seemed the entire town proudly posed on the main square, there is a much less festive view today.
The sad irony of Hinton is that just when it went into an economic freefall, the safety net of municipal services was taken away. For many who need it most, there will simply be no access to rudimentary health care unless the money comes from somewhere.
You may choose to invest that money by using birth control.
And they do need the free health care this clinic provides. For the young who stayed behind, the unemployment rate is more than twice the national average. Many have no health insurance. Hinton is one of the highest infant mortality rates in the country, yet the local maternity ward has just shut down, and the local obstetrician is leaving.
The obstetrician paying $70,000 a year for malpractice insurance to deliver 40 to 45 patients babies a year is just not feasible.
At the Hinton hot dog stand, they're quite willing to accept money from whoever is willing to give it, even from a foreign government.
Well, I hope it's any sir. I'm all for it.
They have a saying in the hills, you have to hit the mule over the head with a 2x4 to get its attention.
We do not expect to get funded by the foreign government. We might get funded by the World Health Organization just because there's no difference in a baby dying in Central Appalachia or Ethiopia or France or wherever in the world.
The British, the French, and yes, the Russians have all promised Hinton a response. Until then, donations have brought in enough money to keep the clinic going through the end of June. But this town will need a lot more if it is to have a future to go along with its past. Mark Phillips, CBS News, Hinton, West Virginia.
And that's the news from our world tonight. Dan Rather for the CBS Evening News. Bob Cheever will be here tomorrow. Connie Stein.